Have you ever tried refurbishing a foldable phone? How to refurbish a Galaxy Z Flip 4 with a damaged back cover and yellow tint at the top of the screen into a brand new device? Test the screen. Touch and display functions are working normally. Power off the phone. Place it on a heating pad. Set the temperature to 90 degrees Celsius and heat for 5 minutes. Softens the adhesive along the edges. Insert an entry pick into the gap. Apply isopropyl alcohol. Slide the entry pick toward the center hinge area. Insert an opening card along the same line. Remove the entry pick. Slowly slide the opening card. To separate the lower back cover, repeat the same process for the upper back cover. Unlike before, you must disconnect the back cover flex cable before removing the back cover. Apply a protective sticker to cover the camera lens. Unscrew the metal plates. And disconnect the battery flex cable and hinge flex cable. Remove the shield. Take out the front camera. Remove the SIM card tray. Then remove the motherboard. Use the spudger to disconnect the battery and wireless charging flex cables. Apply isopropyl alcohol to help remove the wireless charging coil. Continue by removing the speaker. Disconnect the bridge flex cable. Disconnect the hinge flex cable, then remove the charging port module. Next, we'll disassemble the screen. Place it on a heating pad to soften the adhesive. Use isopropyl alcohol with a spudger to remove the support frame. Be careful not to damage the screen. Remove the clips. Insert an entry pick under the screen. Apply isopropyl alcohol again to assist the process. Use an opening card to slowly slide along the edges. Be careful when removing the bottom screen. Do not insert the opening card all the way in. A display flex cable lies at the bottom. Push down as shown on screen. Then slowly remove it by hand. Peel off the remaining adhesive strips. Place the screen on the separation machine. Turn on the separator's suction. Use an electronic glue remover to continue cleaning residual adhesive. Be careful not to touch the screen flex cable. Next, use isopropyl alcohol to wipe with a sponge. Then clean thoroughly with a lint-free cloth. Gently cut a corner with the blade. Insert a 0.028 mm cutting wire through the cut. Then apply isopropyl alcohol and peel off the outer CPI film by hand. Clean again with a lint-free cloth. we confirmed that the yellow tint was caused by a damaged screen polarizer. So further screen separation is required. Then, use a 0.028 mm cutting wire to separate the polarizer layer. Keep the cutting wire parallel during the pull. Separate the sides of the screen first while pulling, then move on to the center. This step requires some patience. Use a sponge with a specialized liquid to continue cleaning the remaining adhesive. Then wipe the surface clean with a lint-free cloth. Place the screen into the alignment mold. Apply the new inner film, which includes the polarizer layer. Clean the surface with a lint-free cloth. Then place the screen into the laminating machine. After lamination, perform a bubble removal. Now let's start reassembling the device. Use a blade to pry up the battery. Pay close attention to the angle, or it may damage the battery. Apply some isopropyl alcohol to assist in removing the battery. Use the same method to pry up and remove the smaller battery. Use a screwdriver and tweezers to remove the power button. Install it onto the new mid-frame. Install the earpiece speaker. Unscrew and remove the hinge. Use tweezers to remove the waterproof strip. And remove the hinge flex cable. The hinge flex cable is prone to damage. It is a common issue with foldable screens. We have previously posted a tutorial video on replacing the hinge flex cable. If you're interested, please check the link in the comments for reference. Next, install the battery. Clean the hinge with a brush. Now installing the metal hinge, and reinstall the hinge. Before installing the hinge flex cable, test the folding function. Insert the hinge flex cable. Connect the motherboard flex cables. Apply waterproof strip to secure it, to prevent water from entering the hinge. Pry off the four magnets one by one, and install them onto the new mid-frame. Make sure not to install them in the wrong direction. Otherwise, it may cause the small screen to display normally, while the main screen fails to display. Apply the pre-cut screen adhesive. Align the screen with the mid-frame, and bond them together. Be careful not to apply too much pressure, to avoid damaging the screen. perform another test of the folding function. Use frame adhesive to bond the support frame. Pay attention to the application method. Continuously tap and press to release the adhesive. Apply adhesive evenly on the support frame as well. Gently press to secure the frame in place. Apply adhesive on the clips. Then fix them into their corresponding positions. Use tape to secure the phone screen to the mid-frame, helping them stay in place. Next, install the charging port assembly. Install the screen shield. Then install the wireless charging coil. Install the front camera and the motherboard. Connect the battery flex cable securely. Apply upper and lower back cover sealing tape. Remove the lens protective film. Install the shield. Finally, install the back cover. Power on the device and perform tests. Check that the screen functions properly. The Samsung Z Flip 4 has been successfully refurbished.